by the orchestra. And it was the music for the Royal Fireworks. And I got myself into one of the big clubs opposite and had a bird's eye view. And it was outstanding. So that was quite an experience. The music for the Royal Fireworks and the orchestra, accompanied by the pyrotechnic display in Princes Street Gardens, watched by Scottie McCLUE and a lady friend from the window of one of the top social clubs. Tremendous. They're tremendous. So I have to say about that. So maybe organized displays, but not everybody lighting off bangers. There we are, and not everybody lighting bonfires. So there we are. So that's what I would think. I would happily. Plus, I also think a bonfire is highly, highly, highly insulting to one of the denominations of the Christian faith, because Guy Fawkes was Catholic. Yes, a Yorkshireman, Guido Fawkes was a Yorkshireman. But can I tell you that what he was trying to do with the gunpowder plot, barrels of gunpowder in the cellars of the House of Commons, the Houses of Parliament, it wouldn't have actually gone off anyway, even if it hadn't been discovered, because the powder was found to be heavily degraded. And the basement in those days of the Houses of Parliament was quite prone to flooding, so the Thames could come in there and would probably even have dampened the powder. So it would have been the equivalent of a canary farting down a mine shaft. That sort of idea. Saturday, says John Jones. Saturday, old firm. Excellent, John Jones. I thank you. Tremendous. So Saturday. So should McCLUE do a live broadcast on Saturday at the same time the old firm's on to see if he gets a viewer? By that point, we might be multi-streaming if the RAM has arrived for the computer. Yes, yeah, see what I just did there. More RAM, more RAM. John Jones, lovely to have you with us. I hope you are well. And Dinky-Doo, I say, from Scottie McCLUE. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the world's top talk show. And we are live. How good is that? The world's top talk show, and we are live. There we are. Some fantastic stuff on here. I can tell you what an interesting, interesting time this is becoming for Scottie McCLUE. Very, very big things happening. There we are. I can tell you. Scottie, I will watch you over the old firm game, says Kareem Zachariah. Kareem, that is a wonderful, wonderful thing to say. That, to me, is better than a knighthood. So there we are. Once I found out that Ricky Fulton and Jack Mulroy were big Scottie McCLUE listeners, big Scottie McCLUE fans, and they told me that was better than a knighthood. You telling me that you would listen to Scottie McCLUE rather than watch the old firm game is better than a knighthood. It's an endorsement from the people of Scotland. I'll tell you. So there we are. How fantastic is that, guys? So we would look forward to that. And Kareem, what I was saying, there's nothing across the screen to say who I am here. So people watching, they think, who's the old bearded guy in the bonnet? They don't say, oh, it's Scottie McCLUE. Yes, they don't know because they're used to hearing me on the radio. So unless they recognize my voice, they don't know it's me. So I'm just Mr. Pop-Up at the moment. That's why sometimes your viewing figures aren't into the millions, shall we say. But they will be. The pubs in Northern Ireland have been ordered to close for 4 weeks. Professor Numptyhead, that will change the whole game of it. How long was that shut for? I ask you. Sorted now, I believe. But, you know, that would be rather good. So there we are. Northern Ireland, full of beautiful people. Beautiful people. I'm telling you. I'm telling you, Scottie McCLUE. Well, there we are. So we'll see how they take to shop pubs, you know, in Belfast. So there we are. Have you just heard that, Numptyhead? Can I take that? Now then.